video, I'm going to show you how to get your squeeze page going. We're going to upload it to our server. Of course, we're going to have to put our form code on it so that we have an opt-in form and set up our autoresponder. I'm not going to go into too much detail on the autoresponder because they're all different, yet they're all the same. They're different procedurally, but they all basically do the same thing. You put a form code on your page, you set up a list, and then you set up your emails to go out at certain times, and then you're going to be linking back to the product that you're promoting. Okay, so this is the copy of the squeeze page here. So what you can do is you can download a program called Composer, Composer. It's a web editor that you can get for free if you don't already have one that you like to use. So I'm going to open up Composer. And then I'm going to open up my squeeze page here called opt-in, and I'm going to change it. Okay, so let's open opt-in. Okay, so I made it kind of fill in the blanks here. So we're going to think of a good headline, a good subheadline, and you can change the fonts of these if you like. These are just placeholders. Some bullets, and then we're going to put in a call to action and our form code down in here. Okay, so I have a start here. I have my headline, so easily lose 10 pounds in 2 weeks. And then do it again and again and again just by changing how you cook. Now remember, I am promoting the metabolic cooking for fat loss cookbook. Okay, so back to here. Here's just some of what you will learn that could put in this ebook. Okay, and then I have the subject of Article 1 in your ebook, subject of Article 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, so you created your giveaway, and that's all you do is you put the subjects on here. Okay, so now down here, we're going to say, now you can use your own words here or whatever it is you like to use. Okay, so I put enter your name and email, almost email, below to have this ebook emailed to you right now. Okay, and then we would put the form code underneath here. So I'll just put form code. Okay, and then you can put anything else you want down here. Okay, so in this case, I just put a blurb down here that tells them that they're going to receive a confirmation email and that they have to click the link in that confirmation email so that the ebook is mailed to them. Now, the reason I'm doing this is because we're actually not going to be sending them to a squeeze page once they opt in. We're going to actually send them to the affiliate product with our affiliate link after they log in. Okay, so that's why we're putting this blurb down here. So all of a sudden they don't get directed to the affiliate program or to the product and wonder what the heck's going on. Okay, so we give a little explanation here. And then we just rdomain.com there. Okay, so that's it. I got my squeeze page done other than, of course, I haven't put the form code in here. So I would go to my autoresponder. Of course, I'd have to set up a form. I'd have to set up an autoresponder. And then I could put the form code here. Now, where you tell the form to redirect to the thank you page, you're going to use your affiliate link, and that's where you're going to send them when they opt in. Okay, so that gives them a preview of that product right away. They may buy it, they may not, but it doesn't really matter. If they do, that's great, of course. But if they don't, we're going to be keeping on warming them up. Okay, so our squeeze page is done. Now what we need to do is set up our autoresponder sequence. Okay, now we're going to set up our autoresponder sequence. We want to set up a 5-part autoresponder sequence, and we're going to send one email out every day for 5 days. Now, you can make this longer if you want. You could put a 6th or 7th one in there and send them out after 3 and 7 days if you like as well. Okay, so what you want to do is go through the sales page and find some cues that you can use to send out some emails that'll educate them. So right here we have the problems with weight loss cookbooks, and you see problem 1, problem 2, problem 3, and we could take these and we could word each of them so that it tells what the problem is and what the solution is. You can also go down and see if you can find some points. Usually there's some points in here that'll tell you why you should buy, and you could go and discuss each of those points. Okay, so I rolled down here what you'll learn and find in metabolic cooking, and we have some points down here. So you could take these points and expand upon each of them to create your autoresponder sequence. Okay, so it doesn't have to be a big long sequence. It can be fairly short, but you do need to give them some information in there. And then, of course, at the bottom of it, you're going to put see some more information, and you're going to put your affiliate link down there and at the bottom, and then people will click on that and head off and come and check this out again. Okay, so we're warming them up and sending them back here each time. And it's a fact that the more people see something, the more likely they are to buy it if they were interested in the first place. And of course, we're going to have targeted people coming to this site. Okay, so just go through the sales page here and find some points that you can use, and then create a 5-part autoresponder sequence. Okay, so we now have all of the hard work done. We've created our squeeze page. We have it all set up. We have our opt-in form on here. We have our autoresponder all set up with our follow-up emails on it. We have our giveaway that we're going to be giving away through our autoresponder. So the first email that comes back to them should have either the ebook attached to it, or you can upload it to your server with this, with your squeeze page. Okay, so all we do now is we upload all this to our domain name and our hosting account. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to use an FTP client to get our stuff up there. And this one's called FileZilla. You can get it for free. Just do a search for FileZilla. And then what you do on your left-hand side, you just find where your files are that you want to upload. And then you just connect to your server. So your host is your domain name. Username and password is the username and password that your hosting provider gave you. And then you can log in. You can also organize your domains into your site manager. And then you can just click on site manager and you can reconnect to your server. Okay, so I'm going to put my squeeze page in a subdomain here, or in a subfolder. So I'll do create directory, and I'm going to call it metabolic cooking. Okay, and then you could also, this is if you're using one domain for your entire market, then you would put these in subdomains or folders like this. Or if you bought it for one product, then of course you would put it in the root so that when they went to the main domain name, it would come up there. All right, so let's upload our squeeze page. And then also we want to upload our ebook. Okay, so I have my PDF here. Where? So we could upload that. Okay, and then we would send them a link to download this in our first email, or we could attach it in the autoresponder. It'll let you do that in the autoresponder email as well. Okay, so that's all we need to upload there. So let's bring it up in our browser while it's sitting here on our domain here. Okay, now take note of what's happening here. We're getting this screen because this file is named opt-in. Okay, and it should always be named index. Let's just go here and rename this. And I'm just going to call it index. Okay, now let's refresh here. And now it'll work properly. Okay, so make sure you rename that index. Okay, so it's a good idea to put your image in here. I didn't do it because mine is, I did such a bad job on it, I didn't want to put it in here. But make yourself a nice image, the way I showed you, a nice cover image, and put it in here somewhere. You could put it down beside the form or wherever you like. But it does help if you have a really good image that shows what they're getting. It makes it a lot easier to get the opt-in. Okay, so now, of course, I don't have an opt-in form here, but if they put their email in here or the name and email, depending on which how you set it up, it's going to take them right with our affiliate link over to this sales page. Okay, so that's the opt-in process. And at the same time, our autoresponder will send them the first email, which is a confirmation email. Once they click that, they'll get an email with the ebook in it, attached to it, or telling them to link back and download it from our domain here. Okay, so at this point, we have it all set up. In the next video, we're going to talk about some things we need to do to get some traffic coming in.